Hello everyone, welcome to another Let's Playthrough with me, your host Tim. And today, we will begin recording Dark Souls, Prepare to Die Edition. Before we go any further, I want to show you my current characters so you have some idea of how far I've gotten. These are my characters. This is as far as I've ever gotten in this game. I'm familiar with one other aspect of the game I haven't reached yet. I think it's called Sin's Fortress, having watched a video on it years ago, when this game first came out. This game is mostly going to be blind to me, and while I have gotten some distance, I still think I'm in the early portions of the game with all these characters. You should also not be looking at this playlist to be one where I'm showing you secrets, where I'm showing you the most efficient way to play through the game, or do anything of that nature, because I'm not. I don't know where all of these secrets are. I've done some things, and I figured some things out since I've restarted the game several times on some of my characters, but the furthest I've ever gotten is, as you can see, level 34 with a rogue type of character. That is it. So you should not expect this to be teaching you how to play Dark Souls. You should be looking for this for advice. I'm going to die to basically all the bosses, at least like twice, because I'm not that great at the game, but hey, it might be fun to watch this. Let's get started. Let's pick a new character. Okay, and I don't know what type of character to make here, so I already have a rogue character who basically gets by using all sorts of consumables and a dagger. I have another character who's a warrior who is using a two-handed polearm. I really wanted her to use one, and I'm liking that as well. I have a cleric because I wanted to see how spells work, or faith, and I think it might be good to make a wanderer and or a sorcerer. Now, I have a hunch of sorcerers as something I want to do off-screen, so let's make Galvin the Wanderer, and we'll just name him Galvin, and he'll be a wanderer. This will work. Ooh, I really like this outfit. Alright, so from what so right now I'm going to make a bunch of statements, and I have no idea how true they are, but this is from my experience in playing so far. Your starting class, when you make a new character class in this game, from what I can tell, and please feel free to correct me in the comments if I'm incorrect, it affects what starting gear you will end up picking up in the tutorial zone, and it affects your starting attributes. But it doesn't affect anything else from what I can see. I could pick a wanderer, and then I could go magic. I could pick a bandit and put everything in strength and wield two-handed weapons if I wanted to. And we'll find all the gear that my character has right now as we proceed through the game at different points. With my rogue, I have found another set of rogue gear, and I found a set of warrior gear, and I think a set of sorcerer gear. And I'm pretty sure these would have been the things that these characters would have had in the game anyway, had I started with one of those characters. So you're not missing anything other than your starting stat attributes. Looking at this class, it looks like he's going to be dex-based. So, okay, dex-based, yeah, probably, looks like he's a master of it, just about everything, which from what I can tell is probably a mistake in this game, but here we go, we're gonna use him anyway. So, as for a gift, I'm getting the impression that none of these are really required. I took the master key, I started with the master key for my thief, because he started with one anyway, and then he also picked an old witch's ring. I got into lots of trouble with the master key, because I began going to places I wasn't supposed to go, but I found some pretty cool stuff while using it. This could be useful for us. I don't know if I should take it, though. The rest of these we're going to find just in the game. Like, we're going to find black fire bombs early on. Twin humanities are something we get. Binoculars we'll find right away. And I don't know what the pendant or old witch's ring does. These might be given to people in-game, since there's NPCs we'll find. I'm not sure what to pick. So, let's pick something. I don't know, I gotta pick something. The master key is so useful. It's the thing. Alright, we're not gonna go with that. Opens any basic lock, initial equip for thief. I'm really tempted to pick the master key. It's so useful to get some starting gear. But no, we'll pick the pendant, because I haven't picked the character who's picked this yet. So, this is no effect, but fond memories, comfort, travelers. Done. Our physique, so this will let us pick how slim or not slim we are. So, I'm kind of a tiny guy, so I'm gonna pick slim. A little fatter now, but whatever. Here's our face. Let's go ahead and make this somewhat commoner. Star and noble. A little too pale for me. Thorn cleric. None of these faces look like my face. This is the thing here. But I don't want to waste too much time. We'll pick Astora Noble. For hair, let's give him... I currently have short hair, but I prefer longer hair. I don't like that. And that looks like me once my hair starts getting a little longer, but I have blonde hair. We'll go with parted center. And for color, do I have blonde? Look at this. Won't be able to see it anyway because I've been wearing a hood the entire time. You know what? Let's go to customize really quick and just make him older because I am significantly older than I used to be years ago. For hormones, I'm a guy. Put a little more over here. Features. Let's go with this. Does that actually work? It did. Okay, cool. Alright, so next, we hit accept, and we watch the awesome introduction, and I'll see you guys in a little bit in the game proper. Here we go.
In the age of ancients, the world was unformed, shrouded by fog. A land of grey crags, arch trees, and everlasting dragons. But then there was fire. And with fire came disparity. Heat and cold. Life and death. And of course, light and dark. Then from the dark, they came and found the souls of lords within the flame. The first of the dead. The Witch of Izalith and her Daughters of Chaos. Gwyn, the Lord of Sunlight, and his faithful knights. And the furtive pygmy, so easily forgotten. Lords, they challenged the dragons. Gwyn's mighty gods peeled apart their stone skins. Witches weaved great firestorms. Nito unleashed a miasma of death. Scales betrayed his own, and the dragons were no more. Thus began the Age of Fire. But soon the flames will fade, and only dark will remain. Even now, there are only embers, and man sees not light, but but only endless nights. And amongst the living are seen carriers of the accursed dark side. Yes, indeed. The dark sign brands the undead. And in this land, the undead are corralled and led to the north. Where they are locked away to await the end of the world. This is your fate.
Okay, hello everyone. Here we are in the actual game. Hope you like looking at our character's back. This is going to be the majority of the game right here. So we picked up a dungeon cell key from that knight who dropped it in for us. That was very nice of him. And let's just, I guess, go out there and see what awaits us out in this horrible prison that we're in. You should obviously expect me to do talking in this one. I'm going to use this in a similar way to how I used Grim Dawn. Looks like he's pranking to open this door. Nope. Sometimes we can slash down doors, but I don't think we can open any inside this place that we don't have the key for. And these are messages, these little runes that we see inscribed in the ground here. In this case, these runes are from the knight NPC, who just basically left these tutorial messages for us all over the place. Later on, these will be from other players. Players will be interesting. They can invade us, basically player versus player, and you can't run away or escape. You're going to have to fight them. Generally, I'll die to them. You can also summon NPCs or players to help you out, but neither will happen in this place. This is a single player only area, this tutorial zone. And that is one massive demon. And I think we'll be fighting him in a little bit. Got all that treasure down there, too. Okay, so combat, which is what this game's all about. Oh, so I'm using a Logitech dual stick controller here. I'm pressing one of the buttons to obviously select this guy, and now he's targeted. I can also redirect my vision by using that same thing. And we can make light attacks by using one button, and strong attacks by using another. Right now, our weapon is garbage. And these guys don't have any weapons, so they're just gonna die. We just picked up 20 souls. Souls are both experience points, which you'll spend to level up, and currency, which you'll spend to purchase items in this game. You can see some meters in the upper left-hand corner. The red meter is our life. When that reaches zero, we're defeated, and we will respawn at the closest campfire that we had lit, or bonfire. The green meter is our endurance. When that reaches zero, we cannot block, roll, or perform any attacks until it recovers. It recovers very quickly if you're not doing anything, like extraordinarily quickly, like within a few seconds. If you're holding up a shield, which we'll get soon, it recovers much more slowly. So the game rewards you for stamina to only raising your shield when you absolutely think you need it. We'll cover a few more of the basics as we keep going. You should also, by the way, expect me to walk everywhere, because, you know, like walking everywhere. I'm also not using DS Fix, so this is going to be 30 frames per second the entire time. I don't have any problem with it. It also means the graphics aren't going to be looking gorgeous. I think they look gorgeous anyway. I have no problem with this. But in addition to these things, it also means I won't have any trouble with certain other aspects of the game, in particular rolling and dodging, which are affected a little bit by DS Fix. We made it out of the prison proper. We weren't like all the other hollows. I wonder if we were going to become like them soon. So here's our first bonfire. It is now lit. Let's go ahead and rest here. And now we'll leave. Let's go back down the stairs. I've always been curious about this. So when you rest at a bonfire, enemies that you destroyed, certain ones at least, will respawn. And that technically should include the one down here. I'm just curious if he did. I can show you guys. Yep. So he respawns. We gotta kill him again. This is kind of a neat feature of the game, or I really liked it, because it means that you can, well, you can put on a podcast, put on a radio thing you want to listen to, and farm up creatures for experience, which I needed to do because I die a lot, so it means farming. It also means that I'll probably be farming in this Let's Play at some point, and I'll get it all on screen. This also will take quite a few hours, probably, and there'll be links or something of the sort in case you guys don't want to watch that all that when that happens. Alright, so that's all we can do really here at the moment. Let's walk up and open this giant door. I don't like the stomping. Okay, we can't kill that guy. We gotta dash through the cutlass to get away from him. And now he's just gonna be guarding that way. Thankfully, he's too big to fit into this area. He can't knock down the wall. And the first time I did this, holy crap, that scared the hell out of me. And I immediately ran into here. Like, I didn't even try to fight him. Our weapon will only be with us for a few more seconds. Maybe 2 minutes or 3 minutes tops. I'm also not going to read any of these messages because I know what they say already. I'll show you one. Get your shield, which is just up ahead. Assuming that you spawn with a shield. I wonder if everyone does spawn with a shield. Oh. Ah. This is either an item. Well, actually, this is always an item of some sort when you see something glowing like this. In this case, it's our leather shield that we came equipped with. So let's take a look at this. This will give me a chance to explain some other things. Now, as I understand it. So here's our leather shield. We see it has a 42 and a sword. I think that means it deals 42 physical damage? Our attack rating is 42? We can see it does no magic, no fire, and no lightning damage. It has 200 of durability, and it weighs 1 pound. To equip it, we have to go to this screen, and then we'll select it here. We can also see some more information about the shield if we use a different button to look at it. So this shield is not one I'll be keeping. So do you see damage reduction percentage? It blocks 85% of all physical damage that we're hit with is what the shield is blocking. 35% of all magic, 60% of all fire, 60% of all lightning. It has a stability of 45. What does all this stuff mean? Oh, and require parameter 6 with a muscle symbol. So this means that when we block with the shield, we will still take some light damage. It's pretty good at blocking fire and lightning, but we won't be attacked by any of that for some time. Stability is our ability to resist being, I think, knocked around or stunned when that's around. And the 6 with that muscle sign means that we need at least a 6 strength to actually use this shield. The Paran bonus over there to the left-hand side says D. This means it scales with our strength there, and not very well. So we don't particularly care about this weapon very much. The straight sword hilt is garbage, but we have a better weapon just up ahead. Let's go get it. Actually, this time around, I don't even want to block, because I'm still going to take damage from this. And this is what I want. Our scimitar. Cool. Let's equip that. Goodbye, broken sword. And we will put the scimitar on. Let's take a look at the scimitar really quick. So, I just finally figured this out the other day. If I equipped this weapon, and then I select a different weapon, I can see what the difference will be in the blue. I'll pick up, so it will go up to 80 physical, plus 13 for the slash. Our physical, magic, fire, lightning, stability all increase. Our durability and weight are heavier than our broken sword, but I don't care. This is pretty nice. We need 13 dex and 7 strength to use it, and it really scales off of our dex. Wow, that's fantastic. A B for that. So we'll equip this. All right, let's go cut us up. Oh, hello. I got these slashes. Whoa, holy crap. So this is my first time using a scimitar, so I get to... That looks like that really hurt. So all of your weapons that you'll pick up have different attack animations, and in fact, I find that I prefer weapons based on how they attack. So there's my slash. Oh, and there's combos in the game. So if you hit... So that's the first strike. If I wait a few seconds, I will only do the first strike. If I swing three times, you can see that will do a combo of sorts. Oh, I hope my gamepad's not hearing that. The same thing with the right mouse button. Oh, and that's pretty awesome. That's a dual sweep. That's the second in the combo. And I thankfully have enough stamina to actually perform the entire thing. Okay, let's go through this veil of fog. Generally, I discover there's boss fights at the other side of these, but sometimes it's just opening a new area with something unique to that area. In this case, it's the ladder. We don't have the boss fight here yet. Let's take a look around. What have we got? We have nothing around here. Oh, we're overlooking where we came from originally. There's an item over here, and you know, I've never been able to figure out how to get to this. So there's something on the corpse right here, but we cannot climb up these broken rocks. We also cannot jump up it. If there's a secret around here to get it, I don't know where it's located. So we're not getting that, apparently. This tells me that either we need an item to get it, I either need to really scour the area to find the secret, or we come back here. I don't know which of those are true. Probably come back here. All right, we're gonna go downstairs really quick, because this will open a door that was locked before that I didn't even try. And this door will lead back to the fireplace, which will activate, so this way I have a safe spot a little closer to where we are now. The game's all about, or it seems to be all about, unlocking shortcuts. This way you don't have to do as much running around as you did last time. So the rest of the bonfire. I did totally re-get the archer back, probably, but we don't need to go kill him again. So, I really like this world, by the way. It's all decrepit and looks ruined. I've always wondered what's happened to this place. We're obviously, I guess we're in the Age of Fire. So, this must be the new stuff? Feels like ancient stuff. The first time I carried that, it totally knocked me off my feet. Looks like it smashed into there. Yep, bounced off the wall there. And hello, this looks like the gentleman who dropped us the corpse. Hello, good sir.
Oh, you. You're no hollow. Thank goodness. I'm done for, I'm afraid. I'll die soon, then lose my sanity. I wish to ask something of you. You and I, we're both undead. Hear me out, will you? Regrettably, I have failed in my mission. But perhaps you can keep the torch lit. There is an old saying in my family. Thou who art undead art chosen. And thine exodus from the undead asylum maketh pilgrimage to the land of ancient lords. When thou ringeth the bell of awakening, the fate of the undead thou shalt know. Well, now you know. And I can die with hope in my heart. Oh, one more thing. Here, take this. An Estus flask. An undead favorite. Oh, and this. Now I must bid farewell. I would hate to harm you after death. So go now, and thank you.
So we'll step outside. Thank you, sir. And we'll actually get to see that he actually does die here. But he fades away instead of actually becoming hollow. So I don't know what that is. Oh, I should know what hollow is. Are we hollow? No. Are we? We're undead. I think it goes not hollow or human. Undead, which is what we are, and hollow, which is what this thing is up in front of us. Now, I want to try something here. We might be able to, there's another thing we can do besides blocking attack or dodging it, which neither of which I've shown yet, but we're going to try the most hard thing to do first, which is we're going to try to counterattack this guy with a riposte. Let's see if we can do it. Riposte are a great way to, from what I can tell, do massive damage to your enemy. Weapons have a crit bonus to them. Is that the critical? I think that's the riposte bonus. In any case, it's really awesome when you're able to do so, but it takes a good eye coordination to figure out when you're supposed to do it. Your shield's, from what I can tell, your shield has got to hit the enemy's swing in order to get that counterattack off, and then you immediately need to swing back at him again. And of course, if you mess it up, well, that's gonna stink for you, because you can get hit right in the chest, face, or legs, or what have you, from a horrible, horrible attack! That's gonna, you can take more damage and feel really embarrassed about it. Now, around the corner here, yep, there's some peoples. Hello. Gotcha, my right doesn't actually kill it. It just does some decent damage and swings twice. I don't know if I like the scimitar. Definitely want to dodge all his attacks. Okay, that still does decent damage enough to kill him. Alright, so far so good. We're almost out of here, everyone. Assuming I don't die horribly in the next two fights. This guy's a little stronger than the ones we have fought. This is a hollow soldier. I don't want to block him. Oh, this is going to be tricky. We can kick his shield. Which will knock him back. Oh, if I can do it quickly. That's actually interesting. It seems like I automatically roll. No, I don't. I'm just hitting the back at. Oh man, I'm not used to having such a weapon that has. Oh, nope, he's making a flask! And he healed himself. Good for him. But Oh. Wow, actually. I'm sorry, everyone. Wow. Woo! I was a lot closer than I need to be. That was pretty bad. I'm used to my R having greater range. My characters are using swords. My cleric is using a mace, but he'll lunge forward with it, with the R. My other two characters are using ability, which they actually will lunge with their weapons, so this is gonna be, we're gonna die here. Alright, so let's walk into here and do the battle against the horrible creature that showed up. So here we go. Plummet around with its face. Now we have to run. I love that this game immediately did this to us. That was us dodging to avoid dying horribly. Man, he looks incredible, doesn't he? It's an overhead smash. Tried pulling. That didn't quite work out. No damage other than what I did when I fell on top of him. There we go. do a stomp. Let's see if we went behind him anyway. We also gained a point of humanity. We'll look at humanity in a little bit. We'll actually be using it in order to kindle bonfires later. But I hear another demon. That makes me think the one down below wasn't this one. So I guess it was a pair of demons stuck around. In any case, tutorial done. Almost. We just gotta walk out of here now. Excuse me, at the awesome looking mountains. This would be beautiful. Oh man, I really like games where you get to explore, what have you. This game really counts as one of them. Every time I enter a new zone, I'm just amazed at the detail that went into it. And I think there's a secret right here. I was willing to explore around. Here we go. Hello. Lost of Soul, the Lost of Dead. So, let's go here and take this out. Souls of undead can be consumed to give you money, or, well, souls in this game. I generally hold on to them until I think I need them to do a level up, in which case I'll spend a lot of them to reduce the amount of grinding I need to do. It actually occurs to me that I've spent very few of them on any of my characters. Alright, so we're done here, I guess. We're leaving. We just walk up to the ledge, and this will do it for us.
Only in the ancient legends it is stated that one day an undead shall be chosen. Leave the undead asylum in pilgrimage to the land of the ancient lords. Lordran.
Okay, hello everyone. Welcome to where I'm going to be spending, I think, the majority of my game here at the... Oh, crap. It just told me what the name of the place was, and I don't even remember what it was. In any case, we'll walk up here once this goes away, and we'll rest here. Now, we'll respawn here. I think we might have respawned here anyway. Okay, we have a gentleman staring right at us. Let's go ahead and talk to this guy. Hello, sir. How are you this fine day, overlooking the bonfire?
Well, what do we have here?
You must be a new arrival. Let me guess, fate of the undead, right? Well, you're not the first, but there's no salvation here. You'd have done better to rot in the undead asylum. But too late now. Well, since you're here, let me help you out. There are, actually, two bells of awakening. One's up above in the undead church. The other is far, far below, in the ruins at the base of Blight Town. Ring them both, and something happens. Brilliant, right? Not much to go on. But I have a feeling that won't stop you. So, off you go. It is why you came, isn't it? To this accursed land of the undead? Ah, your face. You're practically hollow. But who knows? Going hollow could solve quite a bit.
Jerk. Most people in this game have like a sinister laugh. Like, everyone seems to end their conversations with an evil cackling laugh. I don't know about that. That seems kind of creepy. Alright, so let's level up while we're here. We do have some souls to spend. And we can cover leveling up really quick. Now again, as with everything, this is as I know it so far. So here we go. So, we can see that I'm level 3. I have 2,365 souls. 2,364 souls, and I need 707 to level an attribute up 1 point. Vitality will increase my hit points, and all of my, actually everything increases your defenses whenever you level it up. In this game, Vitality also levels up my hit points. My attunement will give me an extra attunement slot. I believe those are used for spells. I might want to cast some fire spells later, so put it at 12 at the moment. Dex will increase the damage I'm doing with certain weapons and help us meet minimum requirements needed for certain weapons. Strength is the same. I don't know what resistance does. It looks like it, in this case it increases my poison resist, and that's it. Like, I'd rather put that anyplace else, really. I don't know what intelligence does. It's probably used for spells, and faith is used for spells. It's used for cleric spells. So I'm imagining intelligence is used for sorceries, and I think pyro spells are not. Do not use intelligence or faith from my experience with them. So we'll take. Actually, you know what? I'm not going to use spells for a little bit, so I'll leave the 2 at 11. Let's level up our vitality 1 point to give us more hit points, our endurance 1 point so we can carry more weight, and we'll increase our dex 1 point. We'll do a little more damage. Now we have only 192 souls left. Let's explore a little bit of this Firelink Shrine area, and then we'll actually begin working toward the second boss, and I think we'll stop after we fought that boss once. Maybe twice. 3 humanity! Holy crap, that's a lot of humanity to find on a single corpse. And he really wanted some water or something. Now, there's actually a few secrets lying around here. That one was not a secret. So we're gonna... Let's go this way to start. I will end up falling down to an area and getting a bunch of treasure chests. And I did all of this with my thief, too, the first character I had, because I really like exploring stuff. And we'll talk to this gentleman. Hello, sir. He is a cleric, and he can sell you cleric stuff. Miracles, I think is what they're called.
Hello there. I believe we are not acquainted. I am Petrus of Thoroland. Have you business with us? If not, I'd prefer to keep a distance, if possible. Hello there. I realize that I have requested that we retain our distance. But I also want you to know that it is not meant in ill will. Here, take this as a token of peace. No, go ahead. It's for you.
A copper coin. Holy crap. Thank you. I guess. We'll come back and guess talk to him a little later. I don't know what the copper coin's used for. As far as I'm aware, he just gave us a coin to get rid of us, thinking we're a beggar, or that, you know, Ovi won't kill him, or anything of the sort. Can we actually attack people here? We can. Huh. I wonder if we can actually fight him. I know you can kill people because I accident or attack them. Ah, see that chest? Is that chest in there? I think we'll be coming back to that chest very soon. In any case, I know it because I've accidentally attacked people in the game, and they stood up, and like, holy crap, I'm sorry, and maybe wonder if we actually can defeat them. Like, I might be able to attack the cleric and kill him. Undead soul, more experience points, basically. And we're going to go over here. I'm going to drop down one of these. So, I learned early on that dying is something you should get used to doing. Kind of like the Nameless One in... Kind of like the Nameless One in Planescape Torment. Although you can't use dying to your advantage, you shouldn't be afraid to die. Because it happens a whole lot in this game. So, it's just part of the game. We're going to go ahead and open all these chests and get a bunch of stuff that I'm going to not really use. But we're going to get them anyway. Cracked Red Eye Orb. Those are used to invade other players. Something I've never done. Maybe when I'm finally at maximum level and have some decent gear, I actually will do it, because apparently that's what everyone else does. Wait till the max level and slaughter me. A Mooring Star and a Talisman. Let's take a look at that Mooring Star. So... does more physical... Wait, if I go here... Here we go. So, I need more strength if I'm going to use this. It also weighs a lot more. It benefits from my strength more often, my dex not at all, and does more damage as well, but not with the strike. We'll still equip it. Oh! No, I do need more strength. Okay, so when we level up again, we'll put a point in that, at least in strength. I'm thinking that I will use a single-handed sword and probably that Mooring Star as my weapons for this character. Homeward Bone. Homeward Bones are used to teleport yourself back to the last campfire you rested at. That'll come in really useful because if we make lots of progress and we die, we lose all the souls of humanity we were carrying on ourselves. But the only way to get it back, to run back to our body, to where we died to get it, we'll have a green glowing... a green glowing mist-ish type of gem area there, which signals that this is where we died. We can run over it to reclaim everything that we lost there. So what was that that just ran across our screen? That was another player. So we're on a shard. We're sharing now this area with other players. In that case, we saw one player run past us. We won't see anyone that looks like... here's a player. There he goes. Hello. And there he goes. He's dropping off and running around. So... he must have failed to jump or something. I don't know why he just ran right through without opening the chest. In any case, we've seen a ghost, or shades, basically. They explain it in-game, but there's all sorts of these other dimensions, and things are going on, I think, in those other dimensions as well. We won't see someone that actually looks as we look, like no one with this detail or what have you. They'll either be shiny and white, because they're our friends, or shiny and red, because they're our enemies, when we summon someone, or someone invades us, or they'll be like that, and we just have seen someone run around. Let's leap off this edge, and then hightail it back to the shrine, because we're gonna die otherwise. No, don't do that. Down there are skeletons, and I am not a match for them. I might be able to win, but it will take quite a bit of effort, and they're not really worth the experience you get. Hello, person. I'm not sure if the people can see me as well at the same time that I see them, but they might be able to. Okay, that reset the skeletons back to being dead skeletons and not living ones. Okay, oh, that's right. And there's another soul up this way. Let's go get that soul. And then we're going to go get an item to increase my healing potion, my Estus flasks, potentially. Oh, you'll note that we have 10 Estus flasks. This is because, from what I can tell, the campfire we rested at has been kindled already. Not all campfires. In fact, I don't think any of them are kindled except for that one. You have to manually kindle them. And you do that by using humanity to make yourself human, and then spending another humanity to kindle the bonfire. And at that point, from what I can tell, you will always be able to get 10 Estus flasks from that campfire from then on, which is really useful. All right, now that's all the secrets I know of in this area. We're gonna hop down onto that pillar. We're gonna miss. Take a little bit of damage, but it doesn't matter because we're gonna die very soon anyway. We're gonna throw ourselves off a ledge. Yup, because we're going down to New Londo. And if you're lost, don't worry. The game doesn't hold your hand at all. You can get very lost very quickly. We're going down there because we want a firekeeper soul, which is used for her.